and thanks to the other speakers who have already covered a number of very important topics. I will now try to give a perspective from the insurance business. Zurich Insurance Group is the insurance representative in this panel and in the contribution to the report. My name is Rui Ferreira. I'm the Chief Data Governance Officer for Zurich Insurance Group. Maybe some introductory remarks before we discuss three main ethical principles that we are considering in particular in Zurich as part of our code of conduct and our data commitment around fairness, transparency, and accountability. The key objective of the EU Digital Single Market Initiative is to improve access and use of data, and as a result, offer value-add growth opportunities which benefit both the economy and the society. With that in mind, we think that the development of any regulatory framework must enable the delivery of those benefits through trusted innovation, as we've been discussing, while respecting key societal values and norms. But like the adoption of any other technology, the use of artificial intelligence in an insurance context is used to develop innovative solutions that best serve and protect the customers and contribute to positive and sustainable societal outcomes. Insurance industry and Zurich as a major player in the market have always strived to preserve the industry's good reputation and to earn the trust of customers and the society at large, while operating, of course, in a competitive market environment. As I already mentioned, the three main ethical principles being considered by Zurich at this point in time focus on fairness, transparency, and accountability. And we'll discuss in a bit more detail how we are approaching the adherence to those principles. However, because society values change and technology and innovation evolve over time, in our view, it's crucial to have a continuous engagement with the numerous stakeholders in the society so that we can actively contribute to the AI policy debate and ensure that the ethical principles guiding the use of AI are aligned with the value systems of societies, taking into consideration their different regional and cultural differences. We also want to make sure that ethical principles are compatible with the innovation dynamics in the field of artificial intelligence. So when it comes to fairness, we should understand, as was already mentioned by Paul, the insurance business is based on differentiated risk-based pricing. Differentiation of insurance is justified if individuals manage consciously risk exposures in different ways. This is not discrimination and not unfair per se. It can become discriminating when assumptions regarding the risk behavior are either influenced by technical bias or when risk assessments are based on data which cannot be influenced by the individuals. However, the concept of fairness is not only about avoiding technical bias, it also implies a broader ethical discussion and adherence to a proper coded conduct regime that is already in place in the financial service sector, as Frank mentioned in the very beginning, and also a higher level of transparency on underlying value-based decisions. The existing code of conduct in the financial service sector already provides a robust principles-based ethical framework, but leaves quite a lot of room for interpretation to be able to resolve ambiguities. A key aspect of fair treatment is the ability for customers to challenge decisions affecting them and to seek effective remediation, as the previous speaker, Maria Manuel, has also pointed out. Insurers favor a risk-based approach to the adoption of AI applications that can cause harm to customers. As such, certain AI applications can be qualified as high risk and deserve ex-ante approval. Examples include, in the investment management area, robot advice for asset allocation, or robot advice when it relates to long-term financial products. In an health insurance context, recommendations that are made based on algorithms for medical treatments is definitely a case where we need to look into with much more carefully, as this could be indeed a high-risk application of an AI application. To avoid unfair bias and discrimination, insurers must strengthen the governance of the data science pipelines to enhance the accuracy of data and also establish a very strong data ownership on the business side. Particular attention must be given to preventing use of personal data, personal sensitive data attributes such as race, ethnicity, gender, sexual orientation, political opinions, and so on, which are already covered by existing regulations such as GDPR. Moreover, insurers must adapt the level of requirements in terms of data quality and model accuracy to the business purpose to be fulfilled. For example, when it comes to providing medical services, as we have just discussed, the level of scrutiny must be much higher than when running targeted marketing campaigns. To reach fair decisions, we want to engage with the various stakeholders, representatives of different voices in the society, to reach consensus on fair and responsible use of AI. Particular emphasis must be given to business use cases with a potential impact on vulnerable customers, such as the use of nudging to influence the way customers live, eat, drive, or exercise, as both Frank and Maria have already pointed out, as well as the introduction of mandatory behavioral change contractual arrangements, as we have seen, for example, in the US market. When it comes to transparency, we believe that transparency about when, why, and how AI applications are used is strongly encouraged. Insurers should strive to provide explanations which are meaningful, user-friendly, sensitive to the context, and contribute to a better understanding of the use of artificial intelligence. In addition, it is very important that the explanations are understandable and intuitive when describing why a particular decision driven by an AI algorithm or assisted was reached, and which are the main factors influencing that decision. Customers must be provided with appropriate engagement mechanisms which enable them to exercise their rights, in this case, over the use of AI or automated decision-making algorithms. For example, customers must be allowed to ask for human intervention and have a human validate the output of the AI algorithm and explain the rationale for that particular output. It should be noted that specific challenges of explainability, interpretability, and transparency that have already been raised are inherently of a technical nature and should be resolved by scientific arguments as opposed to human judgment, which could also introduce unconscious bias. Paul just mentioned that there were recent developments on explainable AI that provide us with techniques that could help explaining the outcomes generated by more complex or non-linear AI models. The different aspects of explainability should also be considered by AI experts, auditors, regulators, and supervisors. The approach to be adopted for explainability in terms of criteria and methods should also follow scientific progress, and reasonable implementation timelines should be defined for the applicability of those criteria and methods to existing models. For AI applications that we could consider low or medium risk, the insurance industry should also develop guidelines for acceptable ex post supervisory control. Finally, in terms of ethical principles, we'd like to talk about accountability. When creating AI solutions, insurers are accountable for the evaluation of the solution impact on the customers, different societal stakeholders. The use of AI must be embedded in existing governance and assurance frameworks with internal policies and guidelines, defining clearly accountabilities and responsibilities in every step of the AI solution or system development lifecycle. It is of paramount importance to demonstrate that internal governance systems are robust and can effectively address issues associated with the use of more complex algorithms. This means having processes and controls in place to ensure a regular review of the accuracy and relevancy of the data and AI models to reduce errors and uncertainty. We also encourage the establishment of ethics committees to serve as consultative bodies on the ethical use of AI and discuss risks and benefits of a particular AI application. Human judgment should always play a role when using AI in any insurance process to provide control and direction. Ultimately, the objective is to ensure that the use of AI applications do not cause any harm to the freedom, autonomy, and privacy of customers. As I stated in the beginning, the use of AI aims to contribute to a positive and sustainable outcome to the whole society. To this end, the industry continues to embrace the principles of solidarity and inclusiveness, ensuring social and financial inclusion and appropriate affordability of insurance. This was also raised as a major concern by the other speakers. To conclude, the AI debate should contribute to achieving the objectives stated in the EU Digital Market Initiative, that is, improving access and use of data, trusted innovation, and generation of new opportunities for additional economic value. AI trustworthy and ethical guidelines must enable, not hinder, the delivery of those expected benefits. Key principles embedded in the guidelines we have been discussing include, in particular, from Zurich's point of view, fairness, transparency, and accountability. To ensure that those ethical principles are based on agreed societal values, it is essential to have continuous dialogue with the various stakeholders in the society.